In this video, I'm going to make a proper tilting table for this bandsaw, like the one on this bandsaw. These trunnions tilt the table at an axis that is aligned with the top of the table so that when I tilt it, the slot stays in place with respect to the blade. I printed out some one-to-one templates, and I'm going to cut these out of some Baltic birch plywood. I'm always trying to nest the pieces as closely as possible in the wood that I've got, because this Baltic birch plywood is not cheap. If you don't have any Baltic birch plywood, I'd recommend using solid hardwood for this part instead. These trunnions are going to consist of two layers of Baltic birch plywood, and between I need a layer with a hole in it. So I'm going to glue these pieces in between to form that hole, and I'll do that one layer at a time. While I wait for the glue to dry on those, I'm going to make the beam that supports the trunnions, and I've already glued up two pieces of hardwood to make something thick enough. I used pretty much the same procedure for gluing up these trunnions here as well, except these have a much wider slot because they have to tilt around the bolt. Now I have to say, if I just cut bigger rectangular blanks, this would have been much easier, but with this expensive Baltic birch plywood, I'm always very frugal. And by now, this blank is dried so I can cut it out. The inside of this trunnion is the most critical for accuracy, so I'm cutting that very carefully. I think I'd be more nervous if this bandsaw wasn't running so slow. I've only given these parts a light sanding, but they already fit together really nicely. Of course, it never hurts to use a belt sander. The trunnions are going to be held on with a bolt that goes through both parts. And for right here, I'm going to cut out a part using the templates for my plans that fits right in that curve. I should really dry fit this thing before gluing it up, but with the joints as tight as they are, it'll be almost impossible to get apart again, so I'm just going to proceed straight to glue up. That looks like it should fit. That was not as elegant as I had hoped, but it'll be strong enough. What I should have done instead is to just glue this on without any dowels, then drill through both pieces, and then insert the dowels from the end one at a time, and I wouldn't end up with a little gap right here. I tried to fit the trunnion support beam in place, and then I realized I forgot to cut this notch in there, and that might have been a little bit easier to cut before I glued this whole thing together. I marked the shape of the cutout on here, And I just set the table saw blade to the right height. And now I just need to put this on here at that angle so that that part is horizontal. I made a bunch of test cuts, and this one is just about right. And I used this combination of blocks on here. And now it fits, and the lower blade guide will go right here. I glued on an extra piece of hardwood here and here to give the trunnion beam more bearing surface. To locate where the trunnion beam goes, this notch and this notch need to be centered on the wheel and the blade in terms of forward and back position. And then to fix the side-to-side position, I can use the blade guides and make sure it's centered on there when it's up against here. And of course, I have to make sure that it's square to the frame like this. And check that it's perpendicular to the blade, like this. I would recommend attaching this beam using either a whole lot of big wood screws or some of these bolts like this, maybe a bit longer than that. But I'm going to use some bolts like this with a threaded insert in here because I want this beam to be easily removable for some experiments I want to try. To locate the holes, I drew in where the dowels from here are and the screws coming in from here. And because there's a lot of downward pressure on the front, I want these screws or bolts to be further back. And so I'm going to put them here, 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 and here. I should have used my drill guide on the first two holes as well, because I got them in there crooked. If you want to buy a jig like that, it's called a drill guide. Google it. I need some threaded inserts for these holes, but all I could find was short little ones like this, and that's just not nearly enough. So I thought I'd glue in some coupler nuts, like this, and to get a better hold, I roughened them up with an angle grinder, and I'm going to glue these in using some construction adhesive, and that's going to be messy. So I plug up the end so the glue doesn't get in the threads, and on the other end I'm going to have a bolt with some electrical tape on there to make sure I can get them in there straight and not glue the threads. I'm just manually transferring the marks for the subtable. That way I save 6 sheets of paper. Thank you. This extra cutout in the subtable is to make more room for the blade guides. But I'm still hitting a little bit, so I have to carve away a little bit more. I ended up cutting quite a chamfer on here, and I also made an extra small cutout down here for this part here, and now it tilts 45 degrees. Now, with the tilt at 45 degrees, part of the blade guide still protrudes above the subtable, which means the top layer will need a slight notch cut out of it here. Got this area all chiseled out to make room for the blade guides when the table tilts. And now I just need to carve out a spot here for the insert. So now with a solid table, I'm not getting any more chatter while I'm cutting. So if you ever dreamt of restoring some 100-year-old cast iron bandsaw, this is basically as far as you'd need to go, because those cast iron bandsaws, there's no enclosure, there's no motor, there's no nothing. I still have a long way to go on this one, but one thing I'd like to point out is running at the really slow speed, it's so nice and quiet.